By the end of this video, you're going to know if this tool called Lindy.ai is going to be something you want to try in order to build AI agents. Now, this platform states that you can build AI agents in minutes to automate workflows, save time, and grow your business. And we're going to look at some examples you can use in your personal life and also in your business. And the third example is something that I got really excited about. Now, this is what it looks like inside the dashboard, because I signed up recently and I've had a little play with it. And this video is going to be really useful for you if you want to learn about how to create AI agents, what type of AI agents are possible, and also just to get a glimpse into why you might use a tool like this. So before we talk about this really cool one here and another one here that are related to business, I want to just share a personal one. Well, I'm sure you're going to get inspired by this one too, because I get a lot of emails from school about events and things happening this week. And it's very difficult to think about, okay, how do I go into my email and add them to calendar? There's no button that you can click. So what I simply did was started the trigger, so add a trigger, where I get an email received from the school. And then the AI agent, I just simply said, when I receive an email from the school, could you look at the attachment if it has one and then add relevant events to my Google Calendar? If no time is stated, add it to all day, add AI before the event so I know it's from you. And then down here, I just added the skills that are used for this. And then I did a test. So you can test your trigger, your Lindy, as they call them, to see if it works. Another thing with a trigger is that you can ask it to do the trigger at a specific time, so maybe once a day, which we'll look at soon. But without going into my personal calendar, it added all these events more or less perfectly. And I think if I just refine this AI agent prompt, then it will do it to a position that I really like. So first one I did, it took me a little while to work out exactly how to set this up, but I love this AI agent flow here because it's very simple to use. You're just using your own language. This is something I'm going to keep turned on over here and see how it does long term. Now, the next one I did was pretty cool as well, because there's an action here that searches the internet. So this one I did on a recurring schedule. This trigger will run every day at 8 a.m. starting Tuesday, February the 11th, 8 a.m. And then you can search the internet for more or less anything. In fact, you can search for anything. The query I did was search Reddit forums for people talking about new AI tools. Create a list of the most popular chats for that day with the title and a URL link. So this is a very simple query I did. I can definitely improve upon this query to make it very more specific to what I'm looking for. But this is when my wheels start to turn and I was thinking, okay, I can search or have the AI agent search the internet for lots of different queries. And then there's another action here. Now, I decided to do it for a document. So I created a document to update the document. However, you can do this, send it through Slack. You can send yourself different messages on different platforms. You can send yourself emails as well. So I simply typed in the document URL here, and then this is what it did. Here is the document. Daily AI Tools Update, February 10th, 2025. Today's trending AI tools and discussions from Reddit. So we have goblin.tools, AI Toolhouse, and Remodel AI. Then it went into key discussion topics and resource recommendations, and it says here notable trend here as well. This is really impressive. Now, I don't like the layout of this, but that's not what the first test is about. What I do like is that it's gone in there, it's gone for the three trending tools, and it's given me this information here. Going back to Lindy here, you can just refine the search on the internet and get very specific, okay? You can say which search engine you want to use. You can use a different AI models here as well. I've just gone for the default, best overall speed, cost, and quality. We'll talk about cost soon, in terms of how much it all costs with Lindy. And then this part here, update the document. Again, we can ask it to update a spreadsheet, so that's easier to do as well. So this here has got me excited about staying up to date with specific things and just summarizing the information in a way that I see best. Now, take a look at this one, okay? This one is a template from Lindy, and we'll look at templates after this one here. And with the template, it has these little notes to help you with it. So a full guide on how to set up the meeting prep alert here. If you click this link, it's going to take you to this, and it's going to tell you exactly how to set it up. I felt a little bit overwhelmed when I created or when I added these templates, because at first I was thinking, wow, there are some with so many steps and so many different conditional things that you can add in. However, this one, I was thinking, okay, imagine if you have a podcast and you interview people on your podcast. This is, you can rename this Podcast Prep Alert. And then if a calendar event started, then you can, in this case, you can have like a podcast calendar event where you interview different people. It'll wake up each event on your calendar. So if you click on this here, I need to get more permissions to authorize it. But let's say you have 10 interviews with people over the next 10 weeks. Then it can conditional go down this path that the meeting includes external attendees. Okay. Again, this condition could just be if it's a podcast, if it's on your podcast calendar, let's say. Then, if that's the case, you research the attendee, okay? So you start this on the sonar model, for example here, this is what it's looking at, and then it's going to research the person. It's going to find the LinkedIn profile. It's going to check your email history as well so that it can look at the back and forth that you've had with this person, and then it's going to send you the meeting prep information. So an email with the Zoom or GMeet link, links to this, the current job title, and a summary of my recent conversations with them. So it's going to give you all of that information. You can even have like an AI bot here where it says, break down their history or tell me their key concepts to this topic. And it's going to give you this information, so you don't have to do this research for this podcast meeting. So this is another one that I got excited about. But if we go to new Lindy here, what we can do is look at the different templates. So if we look at all templates, I'll just discard this one because it's not one I've got set up properly. It's going to give you the different templates for sales, support, meetings, emails. And when I was looking at all the templates, if we go to all the templates, some of them are very involved in terms of chat with YouTube videos. So summarize and chat with any YouTube video, which is great because this is something that I like to do as well. My issue is that with a lot of these things I like to do, I'm using different apps and using different tools, using ChatGPT, etc. You can also do things like turn podcasts into blog posts. Okay, so if we click this one, if we go add, then you're going to get this workflow here. Message received, transcribe podcasts, send blog posts, revise content. And I imagine as you become more involved in the platform and learn the platform more, then it's going to help you in terms of just knowing exactly how to use this and getting these steps done perfectly well. So as you can see, article, example, blog post, excerpt, it has an example here. It's going to take that. It's going to revise the content, etc. Now, when you go to add a new Lindy, the first stage is to select a trigger. And with this, we can do things like chat with Lindy, okay? So this means that you can also have a hub where you can chat with Lindy, the AI agents, and then they'll start something based on what you chat with. But you can also see here, there's lots of different things with Google Sheets. We have Notion, Stripe, and you can also search by app or action too. So you might just say message, your message received from Slack, and then you can create filters on that message so that you only get what you want to use. Now, let's talk about pricing because this is such a key part, okay? So with the free plan, you get up to 400 credits per month, which means 400 tasks. Now, with pricing in these types of situations, most people watching this video will want this pro account if they want to use it in a way where they're having lots of different AI agents and tasks running. So this means up to 5,000 per month. So basic automations use one credit. And there are certain things that you need to think about in terms of like email parsing, when it receives a new email, etc., and filters. And when you're setting up your new task, it's going to tell you this is going to use a lot of credits. So this is basically saying it's $50 a month to have these 5,000 credits. But the good thing is you can actually just try it for free for a week and see if this is going to work for you. So let us know what you think if you've used Lindy before. What type of Lindys that you think you might create using this. And we'll update the channel with more information on Lindy as we use it more. And if you want to build using no-code tools and AI, then go to nocode.mba and check out the different courses we have. We have courses on Airtable, Figma, how to build apps with AI. We also have AI-powered coding with Replit and ChatGPT, Bubble, Webflow, Flutterflow, etc. And I'll leave a link in the description so that you can go straight to this. So just go to nocode.mba. If you want to stay on YouTube, then check out the different playlists that we have on how to use ChatGPT Operator, Lovable Guides, Boat.new Guides, Softer, Airtable, and just check out the latest contents by going to videos here. Okay, thank you so much for watching, and I'll speak to you soon. Bye for now.